Shahrukh Khan, you had said, you had written about this young boy from a Muslim, middle-class Muslim background, who's from Delhi, who's come into this industry and who made it all on his own. It has very big beginning. How did he, how do you think, what made him, you know, make it here?
I think he was very driven. I think he was completely completely convinced that he was going to make it. I don't think there was ever a shadow of doubt in his mind that he was going to be successful. And I think he had no choice. There was nothing to go back to. His parents were dead. His family was not very well to do. He had to support his new wife and his sister. And he had no choice. There was nothing else for him to do but to succeed. And I think he told me once that he never allowed himself to think that there's a plan B. And when there is no plan B, plan A has to work. So I think that's what did it.
But outsider, complete outsider, this industry mein aake, you think it was very difficult for him?
Actually, it wasn't, kyunki jab wo aaye Bombay mein, to unki television serial Fauji had already become a success on Doordarshan, and he was already a somewhat recognized TV star. लेकिन ऑफकोर्स ये भी नहीं था कि बहुत आसान थे, उनके कोई कनेक्शंस नहीं थे, उनको पता नहीं था कि इंडस्ट्री में कैसे हाउ टू डील विथ थिंग्स एंड वॉट हैपन्स. बट आई थिंक कि द टेलीविजन वर्क बिकेम हिज रेज्यूमे. आई थिंक पीपल ऑटोमेटिकली लुक्ड एट इट एंड सेड दिस गाय इज देयर समथिंग इन हिम. सो यू नो अजीज मिर्जा कास्ट हिम in the first film that he did with him, Raju Ban Gaya Gentleman. Ketan Mehta cast him in Maya Mein Saab. So I think one thing led to another. I don't think there was this long period of sleeping on pavements and wo jo classic Bollywood struggle jise kehte hain. I don't think he ever had to go through that, because when he came here, he was already a television star.
What was that special thing in him ki bahut sare log TV se filmon mein aane ki koshish ki hai, lekin he is the only one who made it so big?
Well, that is the enduring question ki what is the special thing in him. There are thousands of people who come, and thousands, perhaps hundreds of thousands of people who come, even from stage, who come from television, who come from Delhi to Bombay, and he's the one who made it. So it is, I think, absolutely indefinable quality, something that sets him apart from everybody else. It's, I suppose, the cliche is the X factor, and that X factor was very much in play even when he was a struggler, which is why people wanted to work with him even when he had nothing else to show except a TV serial.
In a way, at some point of time, it became a trademark of him, the way he acted. Something about that.
Yeah, he in fact is very is very frank about it, and he always, his great quote is ki I've only got 5 expressions, but I'm successful because the other guys only have 3. yes, he is a very stylized actor, and one of the things he also told me when we were talking for the book, when we were doing interviews, was that I always play a character as Shah Rukh Khan playing the character. It is never the character played by Shah Rukh Khan. So no matter who he is, whether he's Raj or whether he's somebody else, or whether he's Don, you know it's Shah Rukh Khan. You'll never forget that it's Shah Rukh Khan. And I think he sees that as a strength, and that is something that has made him into a globally accepted brand. So it's not, as far as he is concerned, a shortcoming.
But from the audience point of view, or from the director's, a filmmaker's point of view, is it a shortcoming in today's time?
Well, you know, look at him, look at their success record. I don't think the audience is asking him to do anything else at all. You know, he's been successful now for 17 or 18 years, and it's been an incredible consecutive track record. You know, every year he will give one hit or two hits, and his low patches have been very, very rare. So obviously the audience accepts him for what he is. They accept his limitations, or they want to see him in a particular role, and perhaps he will evolve into the second act as time goes by. Perhaps that is what's coming, but so far the audience doesn't seem to be complaining at all.
From his point, from his angle, he was trying in a way.
Of course. I'm sure as an actor, no actor says ki, let me do exactly what I've done for the last 15 years because it's successful. He is too intelligent an actor and a human being to just pedal off of the success of a Rahul and Raj. I'm sure that he wants to extend his vocabulary as an actor, which is why he's always experimented. But the way it's been is that the most successful films have always been the type where he is the urban, suave, rich persona. So, but you know, again, Chakte broke the mold, and I'm sure as you know, he evolves, as we evolve as an audience with him, we are going to see more and more facets of Shah Rukh Khan.
Even in production, he did, from Ashoka, he did try to produce such films.
Oh, absolutely, absolutely. I mean, if we, you know, his first production, Phir Bhi Dil Hai Hindustani, was not a success. But if you look at that film, if you look at what it tried to talk about in terms of the media, in terms of manipulation, how the media has become all-powerful and what it does, I think it was a film that talked about things which are very relevant and which are very true. But perhaps it wasn't written in a sophisticated enough manner to really connect with the audience. But I think as a producer from day one, he has tried to push the envelope. I think Ashoka again was an attempt at completely recreating his image, at completely doing something that was different, something that would appeal to an international audience. I think his third film, Chalte Chalte, was slightly compromised. That was again in the mold of what had gone before. But I think with the first, perhaps the failure of the first two, affected what the third was going to be. But I think he's always tried to sort of go out and take risks.
So like, even after the commercial films that he would produce, in between, he would have a Paheli Garam.
Absolutely. I mean, look at a film like Paheli. Even with Shah Rukh Khan, I'm not sure how many producers would have been happy to do that. Put him in a rural setting and have him play a ghost. So obviously he is a filmmaker, he is an actor who wants to take risks. I think to a certain extent the audience has also hemmed him in, the market forces have hemmed him in. But I think it's we're in a stage now where truly there is no market force. As a film industry, I believe if a film is good enough, if a film connects enough, it can be about anything. And I think success of films like Chak De and Tare Zameen Par has proved that. So I think we're probably going to see him doing many different things as well.
But his standard commercials, commercial films, and his this status of this commercial star that he is, his stand is very clear. He is unabashedly, unapologetic about it, that he is a star and he is a very commercially viable star, and he uses that to his benefit. What we see that sometimes he even goes to the extent of maybe performing in private parties. His stand, did you ever talk to him about this?
His stand is very clear. He says, I'm an entertainer and that's it, and my job is to entertain you. And everything else comes after that. So he's very clear on what he's doing, on why he's doing these things. I don't think there's any sense of shame or apology within him about this. And he's very clear that I'm doing this, and I earn my money, comes in from the advertising, it comes in from whatever the stray wedding that he's had, it comes in from these concerts that he does, because films he will never do for money. His whole structuring of his fees and his the way he works has always been that I will do everything else for the money, but the cinema is sacred. The cinema is only for the love of cinema. And which is perhaps one of the reasons why he's endured so long, is because he doesn't do cinema for any other reason except that he wants to do it.
Is that so? Because I've come across somewhere where that he did think that all actors are, at the bottom of it, commercial actors who are working for the job. Does he think?
No. He was one of the, him and Aamir were two of the earliest people in Bollywood to take on advertising in a big way. If you remember, Aamir did the Pepsi ad with Aishwarya and Mahima, and in fact that ad had also gone to Shah Rukh, but Aamir was the more popular star then. So they are two people who have done advertising, and as far as Shah Rukh is concerned, his whole stand with advertising and the reason why he's such a promiscuous brand endorser has been because he says that my bread and butter and jam comes from all the extracurricular activities, and what cinema is it's not about money, it's not about having 30% of the profits, it's not about making 50 crores. I'm sure he's been made offers that are absolutely ridiculous given the new entry of corporates with so much money, but he's never done a film. Once he became, I think, established, he's never done a film just because it paid him a lot of money.
But he did not go on to do, till today, he did not go on to do films like Aamir Khan, say, where probably, he would just give up that image of Shah Rukh Khan. And
I think Aamir and Shah Rukh are driven by different things. And he has no, he makes no bones about it. Like I said, his whole thing was that I always play a character as Shah Rukh Khan playing the character. So he's not looking to lose himself in a character or immerse himself so deeply that you forget the actor. He is a star, and that's paramount, and he's not apologetic about that.
He's one of the first successful, if we leave out, say, Raj Kapoor and his time. After that, he's one of the very few people who are very successful in the NRI audience and also, all the other countries. His status abroad.
He's absolutely huge abroad. My book on him has now been translated into German, Indonesian, Malayalam, which I was actually very surprised by because I didn't know Hindi films traveled south of the Vindhyas so well, and Polish. I mean, I had never thought that people in Poland might be interested in something I'm writing, but Shah Rukh Khan is such a big star in Poland that they are actually translating my book into Polish. So his connect with the audience is immense, and I think it cuts across demographic, it cuts across geographical borders. When we were in Germany, we saw how big he is, how completely seduced people are by his image, by his cinema, by the whole sort of song and dance, the grand old epic Bollywood movies. So he has an absolutely huge connect with the audience abroad. Also because I think at some level, he was one of the first stars that the second generation Indians abroad could connect with. He was cool, he was hip, his cinema was cool. Films like DDLJ, films like Kuch Kuch Hota Hai, talked a language that they could relate to, which is why he was one of the biggest success stories there.
And this did not it was limited only to the NRI, it was the other, the foreign language speaking people too?
Well, Bollywood is very big in certain parts of Europe, in lots of South Africa. Has it translated to a Western audience if we're talking about British people and Americans? It's not as big as it is in, let's say, Germany. So I think that's like the final frontier. That's the last barrier for people like Shah Rukh is once they connect with the non-Indians in those places.
His turning points. What do you think in his career would be his turning points in regard to films?
I think the first turning points were, of course, Dar and Bazigar. Those were very risky films to do, and I think he really put himself out on a limb with those and did them well enough, did them connected with the audience despite playing such negative characters, and that really sort of catapulted him to another level. And of course then came the biggest turning point, which was DDLJ. When you have a film that has run for 13 years, that really sets the foundation of your career, and I think Raj in that film really set the tone for perhaps the next 7 or 8 years of his career about what he was going to play, who he was going to be. From that stage of being Raj in DDLJ, he then moved to Karan Johar's films, which then amplified what Aditya Chopra had started and sort of evolved that whole character much further into the next stage. So I think these were the several turning points in his career.
Shah Rukh Khan has his own following of, he has his friends and associates around him who he is very loyal to. Anything about that, his, you know, the people he's surrounded by?
Well, I think he works with all the people that he's friends with. The Farah and Karan and Aditya Chopra are also personal friends. So I think there's a shared cinematic sensibility that comes across, in their work. And they've all been extremely successful in working together. That helps to cement working relationships when what you do, when what you create is successful. I think it helps you, it inspires you to keep going. So there, his friendships have also been professionally very successful.
Shah Rukh Khan has come to a point where he was put together on the level of Amitabh Bachchan. They were pitted against each other in certain ways. Both of them together, like what the media made it out to be, and what is it actually?
What is it actually? I have no idea. I can't claim to be his best friend. I have no clue what it is actually. But I think the media, obviously, again, it was a very entertaining, yet another entertaining reality show to pit two superstars of two different generations against each other and to see what came of it. But I think it's like comparing apples to oranges. I mean, Mr. Bachchan is a superstar and an incredibly enduring superstar. At 60 plus, he continues to be a leading man and a big box office draw. Shah Rukh Khan is also a superstar, but he's 40 plus. So I don't see what the competition or the comparison was. But obviously it made for great entertainment for everybody. It sold a lot of newspapers and magazines. And so I think the media stoked it till they couldn't do it anymore.
Shah Rukh Khan ki ek aisi image hai jo koi controversies nahi hai, be it women or anything around him. His image in media is so clear and clean about it.
Are you suggesting that he's hiding something?
No, how did he, something like over all these years, usne kaise rakha hai? He's very clear with his stand,
He is. What he said to me again when I was interviewing him for the book was that there are some promises in my heart that I made to Gauri and I have maintained those. And obviously, he is somebody who cares very deeply about his family life, who cares very deeply about his children, and that has been a priority. He said that, he explained it very interestingly. He said that, the only competition Gauri has is Shah Rukh Khan. So the Shah Rukh Khan, the star. So I never bring him home. And he's, at home, I'm just Shah Rukh Khan, the person. And Shah Rukh Khan, the star, doesn't come home. She doesn't know him. She doesn't like him very much. She's not even very interested in him. So, but when I'm home, I'm just Shah Rukh Khan, the man. And I'm just an employee of the Shah Rukh Khan myth, which I thought was a superb way of putting it.
Lastly, the image, the status that Shah Rukh Khan enjoys, unki status or future mein abhi, after reaching to this point, future mein abhi, what do you see for him?
I think, like I said, he's a very, very intelligent man, and I think, which is why he has now already moved on from acting to producing, and perhaps someday will move on into directing as well. Obviously, films is where he's going to be. Films is where he's going to stay. But I don't see him as just acting for the next 20 years. I think you're going to see several avatars of Shah Rukh Khan, which is probably the smartest thing he can do.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you.